Welcome to another video. This one is on the new storytelling capabilities in Progs Dump 3. Now, Progs Dump 3 just came out in late September 2022. There are a lot of features. I'll have a lot more videos as time rolls on. If you want to know more about Progs Dump and you're new to it, I'll have a bunch of links in the description below you could check out. Also, just as a programming note, not every single video I produce is going to be on Progs Dump. I promise there will be new tutorials and general purpose kind of fan videos as always. And I'm going to try to mix it up so you don't get inundated with nonstop Progs Dump. So thanks for indulging me. And now let's get on to the new storytelling capabilities in Progs Dump 3. This video, we're going to cover three new entities. The first one is info intermission text. And as you probably know, at the end of a chapter in Quake, there's this congratulations message when you kill Cthon or you finish up an episode. And this has always been hard-coded in vanilla. But this new entity was created by I Like 80s Rock, and it allows you to completely customize that screen, and you can use it on any level you want. It's really easy to set up, so let's take a look. First, I want to show you what this looks like in-game. So right now, this is a trigger change level. You can see the bounding box for the trigger volume right there. And then I've got a button over here, so it's off, and it's set to is waiting. So now we're going to hit it with the button, and then now it will work. Now, when I go through this, there is a message key on this trigger that shows you the first message. And then there are other point entities over there that will show you other messages. So here we have the completed screen. This is the first message. Set it on the trigger change level in the message key. Could not be any more straightforward. Now the second message. When I hit fire or space. Second message. Set it on an info intermission text in the message key. Now there's going to be a third one. This is the third and final message. Now you'll exit to the map set in the trigger change level map key. And so there it is. So let's take a look at this in TrenchBroom. First of all, you got a trigger change level right here. And you have these info intermission text entities, these point entities. So start here. The first message is up here in this key. And as it, you know, says exactly, you have these line breaks slash n so that they don't get too long. There's a 40 character limit on these, I believe. One, two, I'm not going to count it. But anyway, 40 characters is all that's going to fit on a line. So you do want to break them up with these slash n things. And then also, this was set to is waiting, and that's how the button is triggering this to turn it on. Now, there's also, just as an aside, there's also start off, and this is newer functionality. It behaves exactly the way that this does, so you can choose either way, but you still need to trigger it to turn it on. So let's get back to the messages. So this is the first message. Then what you do is you set another message. So this would be message two. And what you want to do is set the count to two. So that's, it's basically the page number. And then also on this third one, you set this count to three, and this becomes the third and final message. There's no way to turn off the congratulations at the top of the screen. That's unfortunate, but that's how it works. So that's it. It's pretty simple. It's a trigger change level that starts off. You trigger it to turn it on. That just wanted to show people how that worked in a simple way. And then you use these additional pages to tell more of the thing. And you don't have to use this in an ending level or a boss level. You can use this on anything. It's really cool. One other thing to note is, unfortunately, the congratulations card does not appear in KexQuake, but the text does work. I'm not sure if that's something in the Kex engine or in RQuake C, but unfortunately, that's the way it is right now. All right, moving on to the next entities, we've got trigger text story and target text story. Let's take a look at how this is in game here. This is trigger text story. As you can see, there's a trigger volume between these brushes here, and there's a couple of them down there that with different values. So this first one is just the default. So you set your text and it fades, and as long as you're inside this volume, the fade will be there and the text will also display as well. So we're going to turn that off, and then I'm going to walk out of that, and it fades back up. I'm going to walk into the next one. Now, that fade amount is the default. Let's look at something that's stronger. So this is a 900 fade amount, so much darker. Now, this is a little different, this entity over here. This is a target text story. So these are triggers, and this one's called a target, and it's a point entity you'll see in the map editor soon. This is a trigger multiple that will trigger off that text story. What happens is there's a set amount of time that it'll display once you pass through the trigger. And then I believe that's the wait amount. So you trigger it again. It does it for about 3 or 4 seconds and comes back. So here in TrenchBroom, let's take a look at these. As I told you, there's two different triggers. Trigger text story, these are the same entity but with different settings. So as you can see, the message key says trigger text story, and then there's a line break default fade amount, right? And so that's the message that comes up. And then this one, the only difference here is the fade amount is set now to 900. Super easy. Very simple. You can also use a spawn flag to eliminate the background fade if you don't want it. So one other thing, it defaults to making the default talk sound, the little beep, but you can do any kind of activation sound you want by setting the path here. And then you also have a deactivation sound, which is pretty cool. So now let's take a look at this one's a little different. So this is a point entity, as I said, and it has a target name, and then you're using a trigger multiple to trigger it. So the wait is this is how long the message is going to display and how long the fade is. And with the other entity, you have the same spawn flag options as well. As always, thanks so much for hanging in there. We'll see you in the next video.